You're about to see a short video of my experience dealing with the Baltimore City Impound lot. Everything you see was recorded with a cell phone. My name is James MacArthur, and I am an independent investigative reporter.
This is Jimmy the Bodyguard, known in news circles as James MacArthur from the show What's Up Baltimore, also news reporter on Taxi Talk. We're here live at the City Impound lot. Of course, my story has not been told officially yet to any media source, and who knows where this video will be edited and end up. But the reason my car is here is because I spent 18 hours in jail, in lovely Baltimore City jail, over the weekend, because my car was being broken into, and I tried to retrieve the items that were stolen from the guys, and I called 911 and informed them what happened, and I ended up becoming the victim. They arrested me, and there was no concern about capturing the two individuals, the two gentlemen who broke my car. So anyway, we're going to cut for now and enter this lovely facility, this monument of government efficiency that is the impound lot, and we're going to see how this works out. So time now is 2:47. Let's see how long it takes. Come along. Okay, so I was just approached by the gentleman who asked if there was a problem here, and I told him, well, I'm about to have a big problem. And I asked him for ID, and it's been a few minutes. I'm not sure how long it takes for him to produce ID, but we're not sure where this gentleman is, but I guess we're going to find out. So stay tuned.
As long as the Negro is afraid, the Klan is safe. But the Klan itself is coward. They never come, one of them never come after one of you. They all come together. Sure, they're scared of you. And you sit there when they put the rope around your neck saying, forgive them, Lord, they know not what they do. As long as they've been doing it, they're experts at it. They know what they're doing. No, since the federal government has shown that it isn't going to do anything about it but talk, then it is a duty. It's your and my duty, as men, as human beings. It's our duty to our people to organize ourselves and let the government know that if they don't stop that Klan, we'll stop it ourselves. And then you'll see the government start doing something about it. But don't ever think that they're going to do it just on some kind of morality basis. No. We only mean vigorous action in self-defense. And that vigorous action, we feel, we're justified in initiating by any means necessary. With skillful manipulating of the press, they're able to make the victim look like the criminal, and the criminal look like the... We had a couple cases where police grabbed the brother and beat him unmercifully, and then charged him with assaulting them. They use the press to make it look like he's the criminal and they're the victim. This is how they do it. And if you study how they do it here, then you'll know how they do it over here. It's the same game going all the time. And if you and I don't awaken and see what this man is doing to us, then it'll be too late. They may have the gas ovens already built before you realize that they're hot.